First, I would like to commend and appreciate, you know, what the Canadian side has done, you know, so far in the fight against the outbreak. I think first it has adopted the cool-headed approach, and it's a like evidence-based manner. So it followed the professional advice from WHO. And secondly, it has expressed support, solidarity, and sympathy for the Chinese people. And also it has sent the medical assistance to China. So that's all, you know, very much valued back in China. You could see a lot of positive comments. And I think the efforts from the Canadian part is not only to help China fighting the war, the outbreak of the epidemic, but also it's a part of the international efforts to combat the outbreak of the COVID-19.
Michael Spavor and Michael Kovrig have been detained arbitrarily for over a year now. When will they be released?
So there's no arbitrary detention of the two gentlemen you have mentioned. As I mentioned earlier during my speech, it's competent authorities in China. They are handling the case strictly according to law, and their legitimate rights are guaranteed. And now I think it's like the Chinese judicial system, judicial sovereignty should be respected.
When will you produce evidence? When will China produce evidence to back up the allegations that Michael Kovrig and Michael Spavor are spies?
They are in the judicial process of China. So if you would like to have further detailed information, you could refer that to the competent authorities in China, because we are following that, you know, according to our procedure.
You mentioned human rights. Are they going to be allowed more access to lawyers and consular?
I think that all their legitimate rights are protected, you know, that's for sure. You know.